Hello friends, welcome to Krishna's Tech Info. In this video we can see about how to install and configure NagOS monitoring tool on Red Hat or CentOS Linux 7. So NagOS is an open source monitoring tool which provides you the comprehensive monitoring environment to look after all the machines and networks. With the NagOS you can monitor your remote host and their services remotely on a single window. So it shows you the warnings and critical alerts and indicates if something goes wrong in your servers, which will be useful to detect some problems before they occur. So the main purpose of NagOS monitoring tool is to reduce the downtime and business losses. So in this video we can see about how to install and configure the latest version of NagOS on CentOS or Red Hat Linux 7. So first we can install the dependency packages that are needed for installing NagOS. So you can use the following command to install the dependency packages. Now the dependency packages are getting installed. Now the packages are installed. Now we can create a NagOS user and group. So we can use the user @ command to create a user. Now the user is created. Now I'm going to create the group for NagOS. Now we need to add both the NagOS user and the Apache to the NagCMD group. So we can use the usermod command to add it. usermod -g, the group name and the NagOS user. Next you need to add the Apache user to this group. Now it is added. Next we can see how to download the NagOS core and NagOS plugin. First we can create a directory in /root, so /root NagOS. Here we can download the NagOS latest package now, which is 4.6, which is the latest version. Now give enter. Now the package is getting downloaded and it's completed now. Next we can download the NagOS plugin package. Now the NagOS plugins package is also downloaded. Next we can extract both the packages. So first I'm going to extract the NagOS package using the tar command. Now it is extracted. Next we can extract the NagOS plugins package. Now the files are extracted. Now change directory to NagOS. Now we can see how to configure the NagOS core. So change directory to this NagOS directory and run this configure command with the option with command group nagcmd. Now we can see the summary of the NagOS 4.4.6. Now we can run the make all command. Now we can run the make install command. Now the installation is completed. Next we need to run the make install init command to initialize. So we can run the make install init. Next we can run the make install command mode. And last we can run this make install config. Now this you can see the config files are installed. Next we can customize the NagOS configuration. So we can open the context.cfg file to configure the email address for notifying the alerts. So here you can see the email option here. You can add your email address here. Now save the file and exit. Next we can see how to install and configure the web interface for NagOS. So we can run the make install webconf command to install it. Now give enter. Now it is installed. Next we can add the HTTP authentication for this NagOS console. So I'm going to create a username called NagOS admin. Now I am going to give the password for it. Now the password is added. So next we can restart the Apache web service to take effect. So if you have installed it newly, you can give the start command. I have installed it already, so I am giving restart. After restarting the Apache web service, we can configure the NagOS plugins. So change directory to NagOS plugins. Here we can run this configure command with the options with NagOS user and the NagOS group. So now give enter. Now we can run the make command, give enter, and last we can run the make install command to complete the installation. Now the installation is completed. Now to verify the NagOS configuration files, we can run this command nagos-v the nagos.cfg configuration file. You can see there is no errors or warnings in the configuration. Now we can add the NagOS service to the system startup. So run the systemctl enable NagOS command and we can start the NagOS service now using the systemctl start command. Now it has started. Next we can log into the NagOS web interface. So open the web browser. Now enter your IP address /NagOS. So the IP address is 1.23/NagOS. Now we can see it is asking for the HD authentication. So give the NagOS admin username and the password for it. Now we can see the NagOS core is successfully installed and we can see the web console of it. And in the host, you can see the localhost information. Now it is checking for the status of this machine. So just take time to sync. Now you can see the current user is okay. So next we can check the HTTP service. So reschedule this next check and take this force check and click commit and refresh this page. So it is showing HTTP warning here. So in this video we saw how to install and configure NagOS on CentOS or Red Hat Linux 7. In the next video we can see how to add the Linux host to the NagOS monitoring server. Thanks for watching this video. Post your comments and suggestions. Please share and subscribe to my channel. Press the bell button to get instant notifications on my videos. You can follow me on this Instagram ID and Facebook page. For any queries, you can reach me on this Skype ID.